as the points increase, I still want those small thresholds where the difficulty rises. But now that we have different enemies, I'm thinking we can have bigger thresholds where the difficulty rises even more. I clearly have some work to do. Okay, I've been doing some work. Take a look at this. Alright, if you've been doing game dev for a while, this probably doesn't look like much to you. But I'm not a game dev. Or at least, I wasn't before I started making these videos. Before I started messing around with this project, I knew nothing. But now I at least know enough to fumble my way through a wave system that spawns enemies. And believe me, I did fumble.
Sweet, it's working. What?
Let's take a look at what I've been working on. The first thing you'll probably notice from looking at my variables is that I have three enemies. I want to make sure that the different waves are interesting and unique from each other, which is why I wanted, well,
more enemies.
You might remember the blue enemy, Stretchy, from the last video, but he wasn't really a part of the game until now. On top of this, I also made a brand new enemy. Do you want to see him? Would you believe it if I told you I drew him myself? Okay, I'll admit, I might have pulled some inspiration from one of my other enemies, but he's different, trust me. First, he's a little bigger, which means he takes up more space on the map. He's also a little faster than the normal red enemies, making him a little more difficult to deal with. But the biggest difference is the fact that he takes two hits to defeat. This means that all of the enemies now have their own health, but no health bar. I thought that might crowd the screen showing every enemy's health bar, and also I don't know how to make one yet. So I made it so that when an enemy gets shot, but still has health, it shrinks to show that. I also like this because it makes the enemy a little harder to hit when it shrinks. Next, we have Stretchy. He's a big boy compared to the other two enemies. He's tough to get around, a bit slower, and he takes three hits to defeat. Now that we have different tiers of enemies, I don't think that it's fair that the player is only given 3 points when an enemy is defeated, no matter if it's a red boy or if it's Stretchy. Time to put a price on their heads. I'll keep the red enemies worth 3, but the orange will be worth 5 and Stretchy 7. Now back to the waves. This took some time to get it how I wanted, but I found out that Godot actually does have switch statements in the form of match statements. I'm using it to look at the wave number, and depending on the wave, I can turn on and off whatever enemy I want with these variables. If an enemy is active, that means it can spawn during that wave, and I can also adjust the time in between spawns and how much that time will start to decrease as the wave goes on. This also makes it easy to add new enemies and drop them into the waves that I want. Down here, this section sets the spawn time for the active enemies based on the number of points the player has. As the player gets more points, the time between spawns decreases until the next wave. So, what are the waves? Wave 1, we have the red enemies. By themselves, they're not too difficult, but their strength is in numbers, so leave them alone for too long and you can start to get overwhelmed. Wave 2 is at 500 points, and this is when we introduce the orange. Their spawn rates aren't super high, but the red enemies are still coming at the same time. When the player reaches 1,000 points for Wave 3, we start to see Stretchy, and the other two enemies are also still spawning. As the spawns increase, the difficulty definitely climbs. It's also at this time that I had some friends try the game out. I didn't make an executable, because I still need to learn how, but I had them try it within Godot, and they really enjoyed it. They tried to get further, stay alive longer, and even competed for who could get the highest score. It was an awesome feeling seeing them enjoying it, and it also showed me certain things that needed to be changed or added. More waves and more enemies would be awesome, and with the system that I made, I think I'll be able to add them without too much hassle. But that's not going to be my focus for next time. Look at this. this is what my game looked like 3 videos ago, and this is what it looks like now. There's been so much that's changed between then and now, but looking at these 2 videos, it doesn't feel like it. There's a lot that needs to happen to make the game more presentable, from enemies that don't always work right, to other quality of life improvements. Those are the things that I want to focus on next. Time to get started.